Hey everybody, Lance Goyke here. Today we're going to talk about some tricks, some tips to help you feel your upper back muscles if you're not feeling it during your rows. Okay, and this goes for your reverse flies and for everything. Basically, you've got to watch the other 300 videos that I made previously because all of this stuff is connected. All of your joints are connected. If my shoulder isn't working, I've got to look at what my foot, my hip, my knee, all this stuff is doing. If I try to do some sort of row, but I don't keep my rib cage secured with my abdominal muscles, then when I do my row, I'm just gonna move my rib cage instead of purely my shoulder blade. So I don't load the shoulder blade muscles, I load the rib cage moving muscles, which is basically your back. Okay, so if you're feeling back tightness while you're doing rows, like low back tightness, I would venture to guess that you are extending yourself, you're leaning back while you do your rows, and you need to fix something, okay? Some of my favorites, like, let's do these two. So my favorite two would be, you gotta learn how to hip hinge, because so many rowing variations require that you hold a good hip hinge. I mean hinge like a deadlift pattern, right? Like a Romanian deadlift. So if I can do a really good Romanian deadlift with my legs, then I can be sure that I can secure myself with my hamstrings and with my glutes while I do some rowing exercises. Okay, and I'm gonna get a lot more out of those rowing exercises that way because I am stabilizing effectively. I'm not overusing my back. I'm going to be able to train harder. I'm going to be able to train longer. I'm going to recover more quickly. And I'm going to just place the emphasis on the muscles I'm trying to fatigue rather than these byproduct stabilization muscles that, you know, just make my back feel tight. Okay, so first one, master the Romanian deadlift. Watch my other video or series of videos because there are a ton and this is a complicated movement. If you want to learn that. Okay, that was a long sentence. Second one that I would really emphasize you do is the push-up. And the same thing here, we're going to emphasize getting the low back rounded and feeling the abdominal muscles at the top especially, and even at the bottom. If you have if you're a person who does a row and you lean back while you do it, my guess is that you probably lean back at the bottom of your push-up as well. Now, a little bit of that is okay, but I want you to make sure that you're staying secured with your abs while you're doing this. So make sure you can feel those throughout the entire movement. If you can't, you probably need to tuck your hips underneath you a little bit more, tuck your tailbone between your legs, round your back out like an armadillo, whatever visual makes sense for you. But those are your two secrets. If you're not feeling the upper back muscles during your rows, make sure you can really hammer an RDL and make sure you can really hammer a push-up. Last point that I want to make is once you have these movement competencies, or even before then, you might just be doing the row incorrectly. So if I'm pulling my elbow back, but not pulling my shoulder blades back or my shoulder joint back, I'm not gonna feel my upper back muscles. So look at that, because I can't get them to turn on effectively in a way that my body, not effectively, but in a way that my body can feel it if they don't get really short. And they have to come backward to get short. So look at your technique. Master the RDL and master the push-up.